गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन।
गुड इवनिंग सर।
गुड इवनिंग सर।
यस, हैप्पी पोंगल टू ऑल।
हैप्पी संक्रांति सर।
हैप्पी भोगी एंड हैप्पी संक्रांति सर।
सर हैप्पी संक्रांति।
पोंगल
टू। Yes, tell me today what topic shall we write?
So polynomials.
Okay. What about others?
So polynomials.
Sir, you have.
Okay, polynomials.
Write on polynomials.
Sir, could you accept my other advice? Okay.
Yeah. Just a minute. Yes, everyone join the quiz. Join the quiz immediately. Yes, how many of you have joined? Yes, only 8 of you have joined. What about others? Still 4 members has to join.
Who yes, sir, joining, sir.
Make it fast. Who did not join?
Sir, me, sir.
Okay, what about others? Okay, 10. Who else? 2 members.
Yes, sir, I joined, sir.
Okay, still 2 more members. Okay, I'm starting the quiz. Everyone start writing the quiz immediately. Everyone start and finish the quiz within 10 minutes. Guys, yes. Done?
Done, yes, sir.
Shall we wind up?
Yes. Sir.
Yes.
Yeah.
How was it? Just a minute.
I just closed. I'm sorry. I should have told a little, few seconds earlier.
Okay, sir. It's okay.
Who is this, Hania?
Yes, sir.
Anyway, you got first. Okay, Hania, 80%. But why you got less, actually, 80% marks? Sorry?
Sir, I didn't do the last 2 questions.
I mean, I'm asking every one of you here. So, why you guys, didn't do properly? Many of you just got, no one got away 90%. 80 is the last minute.
Sir, for the 18th, 20th question, for the correct options, they were not actually finished, sir.
Sorry?
It was actually not clear, those options.
Yeah, sir, the options were clear. And the symbols were also not there properly, sir. So it was confusing.
Which questions? What were they? Which questions? What questions were they? I'm asking.
Also, the symbols like root and square.
No, I'm asking question number.
So the 8th one, divide n square plus 10n plus 18 by n plus 5. The options are given different.
Okay, let's have a look at that. So let's discuss the paper now.
Sir, I have a doubt.
Yes, yes. In which question?
Sir, it's a question like 1 second, sir. I'll just read it out. If alpha, beta are the be the zeros of the quadratic polynomial 2 minus 3x minus x square, then alpha plus beta is equal to dash.
Yeah, basically alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. So whatever the coefficient of b, negative of that divided by a, you have to do that. So basically it's a quadratic kind of question. So let's solve that. Is that a question from this question paper?
Sir, no, sir. In this quiz only, sir.
I mean, that's what I'm asking. Is that the question, sir, from this question paper only or what? I mean, this
yes,
question.
Sir.
Right. No problem. Can you all see the screen here? If one of the zeros of the quadratic polynomial is k minus 1 is minus the value of k. Very simple. We have been solving this. I don't think so. You guys have a doubt in this question. Those who have made a mistake, they, have you realized how this is going to be? Like, you know, 4 by 3. I think the people who have chose for minus 4 by 3, they might have calculated it in the wrong way. So please make sure that you are just correcting it in the right way. All right. Yes, next question. One is the zero of this polynomial, then what is the value of a? This kind of question, guys, is a pretty easy question, isn't it? Am I right? Hello, people, any doubts here?
No, sir.
Three members have made a mistake in this question, please. Those who have made a mistake, I can't go and just identify who exactly made a mistake. You have to come up that yes, you have a, sir, I have made a mistake in this. So I'll just make sure that it won't happen again. Please, if you're not saying out, please realize that yes, what exactly the procedure to be done for this question. Okay, please. So sum of the zeros of a polynomial is what? What are the sum of the zeros? Sum of the zeros in the sense, like, first you have to find the roots of this polynomial, then you just add it up. That's it. Isn't it, people? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So, yes, how do you find out roots of this polynomial? Basically, just factorizing it. How do I need to factorize it? Just splitting the middle term. How can I split the middle term here? People, do you want me to teach this question, guys?
So, could you do this question?
Yes, definitely. How many of you made a mistake here? I think many of you. Oh my God. 7-8 members have made a mistake.
Tell me.
Just a minute. Yes, let me take this question. 1 second. 1 second, children. Just a minute. I'm just saving your results. Just give me a minute, please. Give me a minute, not more than that, please. Yes. Now, can you see the screen here?
Yes.
Yes. Sum of the zeros of this polynomial. How can I just split the middle term? How can I split here?
So x square plus 2x plus 5, 10x.
Look at it here. 5x plus 2x can I write? 7x can be written as 5x plus 2 that. 7x can be written as 5x plus 2x. In such a way that if I add these two things, two terms, so I must get 7x. And if I multiply, so I must get 10x square. First product of this and product of the first term and last term is what? 10x square, isn't it? If I add, so I must get 7x. If I multiply 5x and 2x, so I must get 10x square. So look at this now, x common here, x plus 5 plus 2 common, x plus 5. So x is equal to minus 5 or x is equal to minus 2. So sum of these roots, if I add this, so minus 5 minus 2, how much? Minus 7. This is what your answer. Any doubt, people? Hello?
No doubt, sir.
Very simple. Sum of these roots is why I'm adding these two roots. That's it. Next question. So if the zeros of the quadratic polynomial both negative, zeros of the quadratic polynomial, how do you find out this? Zeros in nana, What do you mean by zeros? Basically, zeros is nothing but like you need to find out roots of this polynomial.
So since all of them are positive, it should be negative.
One second. Let us. What are the roots you got here? Look at this now. How can I split the middle term here? 99x. 99x can be, how can I just do this? Tell me.
Here, say we only have to find out if it's positive or negative, right? So yeah. Since we know like all of that is positive, it should be negative, both of them.
Sorry, both? I didn't get you.
So since all of the terms are positive here, there should be a negative to cancel out, right?
Yeah. So that is also the right approach. Yes. See, all are positive. All are positive, which means like, yeah, you're right. So it should be negative. All right, people, go to the logic here. How many have you got the logic?
Yes.
How many have you got the logic here?
Sir, I did.
What about others, people? Hello?
Yes, sir, even I did.
Yes, sir, even I did.
Did you get the, I'm asking you the way what I told now, did you get the logic here?
Yes, sir.
Hello, people, are you here or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, are you able to hear us?
Yes, I can hear you. Yes, few of you have told that I'm asking others. Guys, look at this. This is a quadratic polynomial, isn't it? Quadratic polynomial. Whenever you have ax squared plus bx plus c, this is a quadratic polynomial. Some of the roots of this quadratic polynomial always formalize what? Minus b by a. Sum is equal to minus b by a. One second. Let me write neatly. Whenever you have quadratic polynomial or quadratic equation, some of the roots of the quadratic polynomial equation is minus b by a. And product is equal to c by a. Now compare this here. Our sum is going to be what? What is sum of the zeros? Minus b by a. Minus b is nothing but 99 by 1. So minus 99. And product is going to be what? 127 by 1, which gives you 127. All right, people? All right.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So now sum is negative, product is what? Sum is negative here, product is positive. So what is going to be the answer? Look at this. Guys, are you here? Can you hear my voice or not?
Yes, sir.
Exactly. Sum of the zeros is negative here, product of the zeros is positive. See, when this is possible, actually, when this is the case, when it is possible, basically, if both roots are negative, then only it is possible. It's going to be positive. I mean, it's going to be possible. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So this is going to be possible if both the roots are negative. That is the answer. Next question. So polynomial degree 3 is called as cubic polynomial. Very simple. A graph of the linear polynomial will meet x-axis at what? Graph of the linear polynomial meets x-axis. Tell me, very simple. Very simple. How many points? Linear polynomial. If you solve this, how many roots you'll get? One root. You understood my point? So meets x-axis at 1 point. Very simple. Why? Because if you solve linear polynomial, also you'll get only one point, right? That's how. A constant polynomial has degree. What? Constant polynomial degree. Deko, what do you mean by constant polynomial? If you don't understand, let me explain here. Constant polynomial is nothing but, look at it here. Constant polynomial. Basically, let's say the 1, 2, 3, minus 5, minus 9, anything. You take. These all are constant polynomials. All the real numbers are polynomials. Okay. All right. So now look at this here. Now, let's say that if at all I write this, 1 can be written as what? 1 into x to the power of 0. Isn't it? What is the degree now? It will be 0. Very simple. So,
yes, sir.
Similarly, you write all the constants can be written as what? Any constant you take. that constant into x to the power of 0, right? Can I write like this? Any constant into x to the power of 0. So still, how can I measure that? How can I measure that? How can I just find out my answer? Power of the x variable, which is 0. So constant polynomial degrees will be always what? 0. Next, the 0 of the polynomial. What is 1 by 2? Very simple. 0 of the polynomial is nothing but you need to solve that. 0 of the polynomial is nothing but you need to solve this. If at all I solve this, what would I get? 2x minus 1 is equal to 0, x is equal to 1 by 2. That's all. All right. So if 1, 0 of the quadratic polynomial is 2, then what is the value of k? How do I need to find out? Substitute 2, you will get it. Minus 10. So 2 square 4 plus 6, 10. K is equal to minus 10. Isn't it, guys? How many of you got this answer? Very simple, very simple. This is a very, very simple question. Next. If one of the zeros of quadratic polynomial is, I think we got this question already, right? Substitute in place of k.
Yes.
Minus 3. Quadratic polynomial.
And, not okay, sir. I tried it again, sir. I'm getting a bit different answer.
Sorry, what is that?
Okay, it's positive. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's correct, sir. For me, it was showing minus 4 by 3. So I was asking.
No.
Okay, sir.
The quadratic polynomial whose zeros are what? So you substitute minus 3 and 4, whichever the option is satisfying, that is going to be your answer. Very simple. That's how we have to do this. A quadratic polynomial whose zeros are. He has given roots beta. He is asking for a polynomial. How can I find out that polynomial? That polynomial is going to be, what kind of polynomial is that? The roots whichever satisfying the polynomial, that is polynomial. That is our required polynomial. A root ko kya karenge hum log? Substitute karenge. Trial and error method. Okay? This roots I'm going to take and substitute in each and every option. Whichever option satisfies, that is going to be my answer. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Very simple. So next. Classify the number of terms. Very simple. Yeah, two terms. So binomial. Yeah. Very good question. Just now I told that, beta, PH, look at this. This is a quadratic equation concept. In fact, this is not a quiz of 9th standard. This is a quiz of 10th standard. So I just thought, yes, let's solve somewhat like, you know, somewhat advanced level question so that aapko thoda acche wale.
Sir, these questions get shuffled for each and every person, I guess.
Yes, of course. It won't be the same number for everyone. You understood? So for everyone, it will be shuffled. So for you, it's the one question. Yeah. Number one means like no other. For others, it will be like.
Sir, this was something like 18th or 19th. I was just reading and it just disappeared.
No problem. So this is a quadratic polynomial, beta. Iska. Let's say that he has given this quadratic polynomial has two roots. What are they? Alpha and beta. Okay. Alpha and beta. So, kabhi bhi, like, you know, whenever you get, like, you know, sum of the roots. What is the sum of these roots? Let's say that, for suppose, I will tell you a note. Bataunga. 1 minute. I'm not able to erase this. 1 minute. 1 minute, people. Just a minute. Yes. For suppose, if at all I have a quadratic polynomial like this, okay, quadratic polynomial has the roots alpha and beta, okay, if at all I ask you sum of the roots gives you what? Alpha plus beta. Sum of the roots always going to be minus b by a. Product of the roots. Alpha beta, right? Which is C by A, which is very, very important note. This you will be learning in class 11th and class 10th as well. Now you just remember this. What, how to be solved this type of questions. Okay. in class 9th and 10th, you'll be learning it again. Okay. So here he's asking for, let's say that, you know, alpha and beta are the roots of this quadratic polynomial. Then he is asking for alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta is nothing but what? Sum only, right? He's adding, which means sum.
Yes.
What is the formula I told you? Minus b by a. What is the b value? This is here. But what is the a value, yes, b value here?
Sir, ax is, okay, one is a and b is 3, minus 3.
A is minus 1 here. A is equal to minus 1. B is equal to minus 3. And C is equal to 2. Compare with ax square. Compare this thing with this one. If I compare, right, all are positive here, right? All the terms are plus. So he has given in terms of minus. So you have to check it out properly, okay? So minus b by a. So minus b. What is b here? Minus 3 by a. What is a? Minus 1. So what is the answer? Is going to be minus, minus e to minus plus by minus 1, which is going to be minus 3. This is what your answer is going to be, minus 3. Answer B is correct here. Okay, people understood? Now, if at all he asked product of these roots, then what you would have done? Yes, tell me. If he is asking for product of roots, then what is the formula I told you? C by A. What is C here? 2 by minus 1, which would have been minus 2. All right? Clear? Very simple. Next. Hope it is clear to you all, people. Any doubts?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
No doubt, sir.
Next question. So say true or false. Every real number is a zero of the zero polynomial. Huh. How many have you understood this question? How many have you done this?
So I did it.
Very simple, right? Kuch bhi substitute karo to zero to milega mujhe. Yes or no? Zero polynomial, whatever you substitute, you'll be getting zero. So quadratic polynomial, whose roots are this and this? Very simple. Kya karna hai? Phir se repeated question, I think. This is a repeated question. Constant polynomial has a degree zero. This is also a repeated question. A graph of the quadratic polynomial is what? Parabola. You'll be learning in class 10.
Guys, yes, sir. First I got wrong and then... Yeah.
No problem. What is parabola ka matlab kya hota hai? Dekho. Parabola ka matlab kya hota hai? Dekho, maine samjhaunga aapko. Graph of the thoda humne advanced seekh liya, theek hai? Graph of the quadratic polynomial or equation. Polynomial. First, we'll talk about quadratic equation. Okay, quadratic polynomial is the equation. Quadratic equation. Okay, so polynomial, like, you know, parabola will be, parabola can be like this, a shape ola, or like this. Let me write here. Parabola can be a shape of like this. It can be 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 anyhow. Upar wala u aisa. Okay, this can be like this. And it can be like this. It can be like this. Yes, sabko parabola hi bolta hai, theek hai? All these are parabolas only. You samajh rahe mere point? You understand my point?
Yes,
so, on x-axis, y-axis, look at this. Though isme thoda, like, you know, you'll be having, like, you know, parabola is touching x-axis like this. Parabola is touching y-axis like this. Parabola is like, you know, neither... this is the case, parabola is neither touching x-axis nor touching y-axis. Parabola is just down to the x-axis. These are the different varies of parabola. All right. So you'll be learning in quadratic equation lesson in class 10. Don't worry. Okay. So now graph of the quadratic polynomial kya hota hai? Hamesha parabola hota hai. Parabola ka matlab aisa wala u symbol. Samajh rahe?
Sir, can I ask a question?
Yeah, just a minute. I'll just come back to you. Yes, parabola ka symbol kya hota hai? U. It can be upward U, downward U, left side U, right side U. Kaise bhi ho sakta hai. Theek hai? Samajh rahe? People getting my point? That's how the parabola diagram would be. So, hamesha kya yaad rakhna hai aapko abhi? Graph of the quadratic equation. Quadratic polynomial kya hona chahiye? Parabola hamesha. Haan. Ye parabola kahan se mila hai mujhe? From where I got this parabola? People, are you here? From where I got this parabola?
Yes, sir.
Dekho.
Yes, sir.
Mere paas cone hai. Ek cone,
yes,
cone le lo.
From the roots.
Cone le lo, cone. You might have seen a cone ice cream, right?
Yes,
haan,
sir.
This, ye cone hai na, ek cone. Oh, ek minute, people. One second. Let me draw neatly somewhat. This is my cone. Let's say that this is my cone. Okay, let's say this is my cone. See, if this parabola, ellipse, and circle, first circle and hyperbola. Okay, so all these people comes under cone only. Okay, ye sab kya hota hai, ye sab kya hota hai, conic section bolta hai. These terms, this, you know, all parts are comes under what? Conic sections. ठीक है, जस्ट वी गॉट अ सिचुएशन, दैट इज द रीजन आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग ऑल दिस. दिस इज अ वेरी एडवांस, यू विल बी लर्निंग ऑल इन क्लास 11 ओनली. ओके, सो लुक एट दिस हियर, हाउ सर्किल कहां से मिला, कौन से सर्किल कहां मिल रहा है. लुक एट दिस, फ्रॉम बॉटम ऑफ द सर्किल गिव्स यू व्हाट, सर्किल ओनली, राइट? इजंट इट पीपल, व्हेन बॉटम ऑफ द सर्किल, बॉटम ऑफ द कोन गिव्स यू सर्किल. हां, पैराबोला के, पैराबोला के लिए, लाइक फॉर गेटिंग पैराबोला, व्हाट आई हैव टू डू, फ्रॉम दिस साइड थोड़ा इसको ऐसे यू शेप में कट कर दो, फ्रॉम दिस साइड यू शेप में कट कर देंगे. All right, if you cut you in U shape, something like this, in a curve shape, like, you know, you take a paper, man, you take a paper and just cut side of that paper in a U shape. Isn't it look, won't it be look like the parabola or U shape, you know, this kind of symbol? You understood my point? You just take a paper and just make sure that you're folding it in a cone shape, and the side of the paper you are just cutting in a cross way like this. Thoda isa cross mein cut karo, haath se cut kar sakte ho, you can just tear with your hands. All right, so and that particular shape gives you parabola. And ellipse ka matlab kya hota hai? Ellipse ka matlab iska pooch hai na, tail of this. All right,
yes,
just cut the tail of this conic section. If you cut it, so it looks like, you know, ellipse. All right, or else aapko aisa nahi samajh mein aa raha hai, ha uska pooch kaat lenge to circle milega. Ha, aapko exact ellipse hona chahiye, to kya karna hai, iska side hai na, side mein se thoda aisa kaato, like, you know, you just cut, you will cut like this, right? You will cut in a U symbol, right? After cutting that, open the paper. Open the paper, aapko ellipse ka symbol. Ellipse will be like egg symbol, like this. Ellipse will be not circle, ye ho gaya, ellipse ye ho gaya. Theek hai? This is circle. This is ellipse. You understood my point? Thoda difference hota hai dono ko.
Yes, sir.
Hyperbola ka matlab kya hota hai? Hyperbola ka matlab dekho. I am just telling you, we got a situation, that is the reason I am telling you what exactly it denotes. Theek hai? Hyperbola ka matlab kya hota hai? Dekho. Hyperbola क्या होता है, हमेशा ऐसा होता है, देखो, ठीक है, this is how the hyperbola, this is what hyperbola, ठीक है, parabola and hyperbola थोड़ा, like, you know, almost they'll be same only, you understand my point, it can be like this also,
yes sir,
it can be like this also, it can be like this also, this is what the hyperbola will be, this is how the hyperbola, ठीक है, so these are the, all these four are the sections of what, cone, so that is what we called a conic section. Under a lesson called conic section, we'll be learning circles, parabola, ellipse and hyperbola. This is a lesson in class 11. ठीक है, so we got a situation, I'm telling you, quadratic equation का graph क्या होता है, हमेशा parabola होता है, ठीक है, yes.
Yes, sir.
Next, so sum of the squares of the zeros of the quadratic polynomial is this much, the value of k. Very good question. How many have we done this? Sum of the squares of the zeros. First, what you have to do? You have to find out the value of k. I mean, first you have to find out roots, sum of the squares of the zeros of the quadratic polynomial is 25/36. Then what is the value of k? Come on. How did you solve this, guys?
So, 1 minute.
How
so
many?
This is the doubt, sir. Yeah.
No problem. Let me teach you. Basically, this is a very, very good question. I'm asking how many of you, anyone of you have solved, or did you like, you know, guess it?
Sir, I got this question wrong.
I guessed it and I got it correct.
I guessed it and I got it correct.
Same here.
Almost everyone guessed. Huh?
Yes, sir, even I guessed.
Okay, no problem. I'll teach you. 1 second, yeah, let me take this question. Basically, this is a class 10th question only, but I wanted deliberately, I just wanted to what is that? Give you the 10th standard quiz on polynomials. Let's see how far you guys will solve it and make it. That's what the reason I just gave you, no problem. Basically, beta, just now I told you the concept whichever we have discussed just now, based upon that concept only you have to solve. Sum of the squares of the zeros. Zeros means what? Factors or no solutions. So what is the factors of this quadratic polynomial? This is a quadratic polynomial only, right? Having degree 2. Having degree 2 is called as quadratic polynomial. Let's say that alpha and beta are the roots. All right. Let's say alpha and beta are the roots of this, are the roots or zeros. Okay. Then alpha plus beta, kya hota beta? What is alpha plus beta? Minus b by a. So minus 1 by 6. Isn't it? Hello? Yes, sum of the roots. Sum of the roots.
Minus b by a is equal to 25 by 36.
Wait. No, not that is the case. That is sum of the squares of that. This is
yes, sir. So we have to square it.
Wait. Sum alpha plus beta is this much. Alpha beta is what? C. What is C here? K.
C is K, yeah.
By 6. C by A. I told you right formula. Alpha yes. plus beta kya hota hai? B minus B by A. Alpha beta kya hota hai? C by A. Haan. Now what he has given? Sum of the squares of the zero. Sum of the squares. Matlab dekho square of this. Sum of the squares of this given how much? Given. What he has given? Given 25 by 36. Now look at this. Very, very simple. Dekho beta, mere paas, dekho, you might have got an idea now. So squaring on both sides karo ispe.
Yes, sir.
Very simple. First equation. So from the first equation, if I do squaring on both sides, what would he get?
Minus
1
by
6 square, yes. So look at this. Why? How did I get an idea to do this? Well, because I have alpha square plus beta square. If I do squaring on both sides, I'll get this.
Plus 2 alpha beta.
So 1 by 36. Alpha by square plus beta square, how much beta? 25 by 36. Plus 2 into alpha plus beta, how much beta? K by 6. Now K 1 by 36. Only unknown term is what? K here. Now, can't you find out this? Very easy.
Yes, 2
K by 6 is equal to 1 by 36 2 minus 25 by 36. Aditya, yes. Are you here, Aditya?
Yes, sir.
Are you able to understand?
Yes, sir.
Yes, look at this here. 6 ones, 6 6. 2 ones, 2 12s. 6 ones, again 6 twos. So what is the answer is going to be now? K value is going to be minus 2?
Yes, sir.
Very simple. After this, very simple. So all I have done here is what? I took alpha and beta are the roots of the given quadratic polynomial. And whenever you have a quadratic polynomial beta, he's asking for sum of the squares of the roots. Sum. Look at this here. Alpha square plus beta square. This is what this meaning, right? Sum of the squares. All right. That is what it means to you. Huh. Now, sum of the squares of the quadratic polynomial is given this much. So now, as per the definition, as I told you, alpha plus beta kya hota hai? Minus b by a. And alpha beta kya hota hai? Formula c by a. I use this formula to just get this one and this one. After that, I just squared on both sides to the equation number one. I got k value from that very easily. After substitution, everything, I just got that. Very simple. Isn't it, people? Isn't it? Yes.
Yes, sir.
So that's how I got minus 2 here. Hope it is clear to you all now. Now you got it, right? Tomorrow again, we'll write.
Yes, I understood.
Yeah, tomorrow we'll write a quiz on. Probably this topic only. Let's see how many of you will just do that. Okay, next question. What is the degree of this polynomial? Very simple. What is the degree? 5. Isn't it? So divide this by this. Will not be able to divide this. Very simple, right, guys? Will you divide this by using long division method? Hello? Guys, how many of you done this question correctly?
I mean, sir, n is equal to minus 5, replace it.
Yeah. N is just equal, n plus, sorry, I didn't get you. N plus 5?
Sir, here, since all the remainders are different, we can find the right remainder and just get the answer. So, if we take n plus 5 as g of x, so n plus 5 is equal to 0, so n is equal to minus 5. Is there like the divisor for it? So minus 5.
Replace it with n. Perfect. Yes. How many have you done this question, guys? People, what have you done or not?
Sir, I did. Sir, it was correct.
One second. It got stuck. Ayo. Can you see the screen?
Yes, sir. We are able to see you.
Yeah, it got stuck for me. Yes, I hope it is clear now. So this was the question paper. How did you feel it? I mean, how the depth of the question?
It was exciting.
It's very good.
Yes, sir.
Hopefully, yeah, Hariya got like 80%. Very good. Akshit, 80. Aditi, 75. Piyush, 75. Tayaba. Can you see the results here?
No, sir. We are only able to see the question.
Yes, sir. The question is there.
No, no. Can you see the screen now? I'm just sharing the screen. Hello?
We are unable to see. Okay.
Now?
It flickered for a second. Yeah, now it's visible.
Yes. So, why Pranav, you got less? Pranav? Hello? Yes, Pranav, are you here or not? He's not here. Devashree, why you got less? I don't find Nitya is talking in the class. Modita, Sujay is not talking in the class today. Devashree, no response. Mm-hmm. Aditi, yes, she is here. Akshit, very good, Akshit. Mm-hmm. Akshit, how did you feel the question paper? How was the paper? Akshit, are you here? Pranav sir was the glitches where I'm going to continue the quiz after a few. No problem, Pranav. Make sure that you are having a proper device in the next quiz. Okay. Yes. Sujay, are you here, Sujay? No problem, Pranav. No problem.
Yes, sir.
You can solve it.
Sir, I'm here.
Why you got less?
Sir, most of the questions were hard.
Most of the questions were hard. You can't say hard, Sujay. Except to 2 to 3 questions, everything was easy only. Everything you can solve it very easily. 2 to 3 questions you can... Yeah, I understand 2 to 3 questions were difficult. Okay, at least... Yeah, for this paper, for your standard, getting 80 to 85% is very, very good actually. Yeah.
Sir, 1 or 2 questions were repeated, sir.
Yeah, that too. I'm just... You can... 1 or 2 questions are repeated actually. Still, you can get good marks. Okay, Sujay, okay, make sure that you are just going through these mistakes. And guys, how many of you seen that I have shared a worksheet to you all?
Sir, I have seen.
Guys, worksheet on polynomials has been given to you. Worksheet on polynomials given to you all. How many of you just gone through that?
Me, sir.
I have gone through it.
Yes, 1 second, let me share. Now, can you see the screen here? Look at this. If you observe this worksheet, yeah. Worksheet on polynomials dated on 10th. Look at this here. Oh, Pranav already started. Very good, Pranav. Fantastic. He started, you know, and started upload. Did you finish, Pranav? He has done actually. Very good, Pranav. Look at this here. He has solved. Very, very good. Yes. Not, I think he did not solve all the questions. Very good, Pranav. Very good. Okay. So look at this here. So what I asked you to do before 20th, in the sense you can't submit on 20th alone and submit it. So everyone make sure that you guys are solving it. You guys are solving it before 20th itself. Okay, solve every day 3 questions. Once you're done with, you can finish it very easily actually. Only one paper is there. Only how many? 12 plus 9. So 21 questions are there. So you can finish it up this question.
Okay, sir.
All right, people. So everyone finish this very easily. If you sit for 1 hour, you'll just finish it up. Okay. And yes. Understood or not? Yes, Nitya. Nitya, I don't see you're active in the class. Be active, Nitya. Any problem, Nitya?
No, sir.
Any doubts, beta?
No doubt.
Fantastic. Bhargav? Bhargav?
Yes, sir.
Huh. Tell me, Bhargav. Any doubts?
Yes, sir. No, sir.
Okay. Chalo then. Jo Happy Pongal once again. Have fun and don't roam outside. And anyhow, it's a lockdown, I think, in Telangana. Am I right? Thank you.
No, sir, we don't have lockdown. We have only institution are closed.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Have a nice day.
Thank you all.